हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू वन मोर वीडियो ऑफ स्पेशल बायोटॉनिक। स्टूडेंट्स, यू ऑल मस्ट हैव स्टडीड ऑर्गेनिजम्स लाइक अमीबा, पैरामेशियम एंड यूग्लिना। दीज ऑर्गेनिजम्स बिलोंग टू किंगडम प्रोटिस्टा। देर आर ऑल्सो नोन एग्जाम्पल्स लाइक मलेरिया। वी नो दैट दिस मलेरिया स्प्रेड्स थ्रू female anopheles mosquitoes and it is one of the leading cause of death in the world. The main causative agent of malaria is plasmodium. It is also an example of protista. One more such example is red tide. It is also called algal blooms caused by gonialax. These gonialax are nothing but the members of protista. So students, we are very much familiar with this group. So in this video, we will be learning their features and types in detail. So watch the video till the end. Students, these organisms are unicellular and eukaryotic in nature. That is, they show distinct nucleus and other membrane-bound cell organelles. They show autotrophic as well as heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Autotrophic organisms are photosynthetic in nature, whereas heterotrophic organisms shows huge diversity such as holozoic, saprophytic, and even parasitic. Students, these organisms are abundantly found in fresh water as well as marine water. They show locomotion with the help of cilia, flagella, and even pseudopodia. They are characterized by presence of mitosis and even meiosis in the life cycle. Students, their cytoplasm is constantly moving. This phenomena is called cyclosis or cytoplasmic streaming. It helps in circulation of material inside the single cell. Flagella and cilia shows 9+2 arrangement of microtubules, that is 11 microtubules in total. Students, they show reserve food as starch, paramylum, glycogen and fat. Their reproduction is both asexual and sexual. Asexual reproduction takes place with the help of binary fission or budding or cyst formation. Students, if you're finding this video interesting, then please do like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you. Students, this group is further divided into 5 subgroups. That is, plant-like protista, which are also called diatoms, animal-like protista, dinoflagellates, fungi-like protista, and euglenoids. The first group is plant-like protista. This group is also called chrysophyta or diatoms. They are found in both fresh as well as marine water. They are commonly found floating on the water surface as they store their food as lipids. Students, the diatom shows beautiful design on their surface. It is due to deposition of silica in their cell wall. Now, look at this structure. It is a typical structure of diatom. They show soapcase-like structure. its upper lid or cover is called epitheca, whereas the lower part is called hypotheca. These diatoms have diverse applications in industries. The second group is animal-like protista, which are also called protozoans. These group of organisms don't have cell wall. They are believed to be primitive animal forms. Students, this group is further divided into four subgroups. The first is Sarcodina, which includes organisms like amoeba and entamoeba. They show locomotion with the help of pseudopodia. The examples like Leishmania, Giardia and Trichomonas, they show locomotion with the help of flagella. So therefore this group is called flagellata or flagellates. Ciliate is a third group and they show locomotion with the help of cilia. The example is Paramecium. And the fourth group is sporozoans. These organisms don't have any structure for locomotion. The example is Plasmodium. Students, members of this group cause many diseases in human. Few examples are: Leishmania causes Kala Azar, Giardia causes Giardiasis, Trichomoniasis is caused by Trichomonas vaginalis, the sleeping sickness is due to Trypanosoma, Plasmodium spreads malaria in human and other organisms, and the last one is Entamoeba histolytica, which causes amoebiasis. The third group is dinoflagellates. They are unicellular and have cell wall made up of cellulose. Its cell wall is divided into plates, which gives an organism an armored appearance. They show two flagella, that is dinoflagellates. Their examples are Goniolax, Glenodium and Noctiluca. Students, as we have said earlier, Goniolax causes red tide or algal blooms. The fourth group is the fungi-like protista. They are also called Myxomycota. They are saprophytic organisms found on decaying leaves. Their cell aggregate form large cell mass called Plasmodium. The spores produced by Plasmodium are very tough and survive in extreme conditions. Students, the last group is Euglenoids, which include organisms like Euglena. They show locomotion with the help of flagella. They don't have the cell wall, but their body is covered with the thick protective covering called pellicle. It is made up of protein. These organisms shows dual mode of nutrition. That is, in presence of sunlight, they are photosynthetic, and in absence of sunlight, they are holozoic. Therefore, it is called mixotrophs. So students, I hope you are clear with all the features of Kingdom Protista. In the next video, I'll talk about the plants and animal briefly. So stay home, stay safe. Thank you.